First for Indiana, Robinson. They've got Turner. A big game for this young man, making his NBA debut. Then it's Paul George, and it's Young in at the four-man position. And for Boston, Isaiah Thomas out there with Avery Bradley. And over down the middle, a tremendously hard-working and versatile big man out of the Dominican Republic, Al Horford. Then it's Jay Crowder, and it's Johnson in at the four-slot. So he comes up empty at the line.
You know, in order to win your division, you have to be able to win games against the rest of your conference, and that's exactly what Indiana did last season. Tough team and a tough division, and they gave no ground to other teams in the East.
And it's Paul George with the foul. That's his first foul.
Tough call there and a tough break for the defense.
But you know, I think you could still see him kind of sliding in there. I don't have a problem with the call.
Here's Walker, and George with the block. Leads him in there. T picks to Robinson. Young outside. Puts up a three. Defensive rebound. Here's Teague. And he banks in the layup. Teague's got the opening bucket of the night here for the Pacers.
They always like to get that first lead of the game.
Yeah, you know, Steve, a good way to set the tone early on there.
And the Pacers, as you mentioned, Clark, very solid against the other teams in the East as they cruise to a 31-20 record against the rest of the conference.
And really, that's because this team is built to handle anything that's thrown at them, given it's a big, strong, kind of old-school team. They'll pound you inside, they rebound, they protect the paint. There aren't a lot of matchups that seem to bother this team.
Here's Boston now. Four-point game. Crowder kicks to Horford. Dishes it to Crowder. Nice ball movement by Boston. There's the lob to the hoop. The slam dunk by Robinson.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
You know, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
Yeah, what a beautiful connection on that play. Big step forward once again for Jeff Teague last season. He continued to up his scoring and assist totals and had one of his best years from the free throw line to date.
Now here's Johnson. After the miss from Turner. About 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Horford attacking.
Well, I hope they start getting warmed up here soon. That's 0-for-4 to this point.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
But Kevin, here's what the Celtics head coach had to say when we spoke just a few minutes ago. It was a simple defensive strategy he laid out for me. He said, we're going to try to pester the heck out of the ball handlers and force them into some mistakes, come away with some steals. Overall, just annoy them as much as possible. Create as much havoc as we possibly can, guys.
Okay, thank you, Doris. And the defensive approach, guys, how do you think that'll play out here?
I don't know, Kevin. I'm not sure they should be more focused on their opponent than they are on themselves.
That is sort of the way it sounds, Steve, but still, I don't think a defense-first mindset is ever a bad thing.
Out of bounds, Indiana takes possession. Pacers have gone 3-5 shooting the ball so far. And the call will be against Jeff Teague. That's his first foul.
Terrific defensive play to cut him off and square up.
And he took a shot. Excellent toughness to get in there and make a play. I love that kind of work.
Thomas kicks to Johnson. Looking to end the run. Blocked. George dishes to Turner. Gives him the lead pass. Young left side. Over Johnson. A second chance effort. Horford with the rebound.
Had a pretty good look at the basket, but defensively they did a nice job rotating, forcing the miss.
Usually if he gets to the rim, he's converting it into points. But the defense stood tall there.
To the paint. And it's out of bounds. The Celtics will take it the other way.
Boy, they couldn't hook up there on what's really a pretty basic pass.
And here in the first, about 3 minutes in, Thomas passes to Crowder. Horford gets the bucket.
Well, it took a while, but somebody finally got a shot to go.
You know, I'm starting to get a little concerned for them. I mean, it hadn't been pretty to this point.
And George, here we go. And the shot is good. George has got his first basket.
I don't know who was supposed to be on him there, but clearly a mistake by the defense.
Johnson, defended by Young. Outside Thomas, fade away. No good. Pacers leading by seven. Here's Teague, the kick out to Young. The feed now to Turner. Robinson left side, outside, George. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Thomas goes in, tries from seven. And all of them run that time before dropping in.
Boy, that was impressive, Buck. He did not hesitate to take the ball right up against the bigger defender.
Boy, I like that aggressive mindset there, Steve.
And one of the things you know you're going to see from this guy is his skill running the pick and roll. He knows exactly how to run a defender directly into that screen and then the beautiful passing ability, setting up layups and jump shots.
And he is also a very rugged player at the defensive end. I mean, he will pull his way through any screen if it means staying on his man.
Monte Ellis, he's checked in for Robinson.
Guys, the Celtics went from being a powerhouse in the East and middle of the pack last season, but they still protected their home court as well as anybody. Easy to find inspiration here with the parquet floor under your shoes and the banners hanging over top.
Here's George. Tries to keep it alive. Out of bounds, Boston takes possession. Celtics trail by six. Thomas up top. Team covering. Pope loose. Here's Horford. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. You do have to love the parquet floor here, as you said, Clark. The pride, certainly a factor last season, as the Celtics were able to finish, Steve, with a 27-13 record here at their home.
And even though the Celtics would end up just as a seventh seed in the East, you knew they would control their home floor just because of their veteran experience, their talent, their coaching. So they were really able to ride that home court into the playoffs.
Boston's gone 0-2 from deep here. Repko kicks to Horford. The shot no good. Excellent D there from George.
Oh, boy, he is just cold as ice. I don't think he's going to be the one to help them cut into the lead.
Indiana moving the ball around. There's Ellis with the three ball. Goes back up, and Turner finishes inside. Turner's got his second bucket of the night.
In terms of rebounding, it's been a sensational opening quarter.
I like sensational. That's a good word for it.
Here's Thomas. Kicks it out to Bradley. Back to Thomas. From the arc. Good. Thomas got 5 points so far.
I like the offensive awareness to exploit that lack of coverage on that play.
And George, here we go. Ellis. Turner dishes to George. And here's Ellis from beyond the arc. Ellis can't get that one to fall either. Here's Thomas. Nice D from Brooks. Indiana leading by six. Young passes to Turner. Great pass to set up the lay-in. Turner's got his third basket of the night right there.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, just piling up points in the paint.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
And this quarter has really been off the mark. He just looks a little bit unsettled.
And the pass to Horford. The jump hook. The shot's good from Jurepko. So the Pacers call timeout, their first of the game.
You knew that at some point the window for the group of Celtics that had won a title was going to close. I mean, it was inevitable. But last year seemed like they were going to go for one last hurrah as they added some depth and looked to reload for another run.
Matching up on the changes now for Indiana. Al Jefferson is checked in for Turner. Sullivan comes in for Thaddeus Young. And it's C.J. Miles in for Paul George. Good on the shot.
Gets that to go, but it's been a bumpy ride so far. Just 1-5 for him overall.
And getting back to the Celtics, Rondo is injured. A lot of people expected that to start the rebuilding process. Ended up standing back at the deadline, Steve. Even though they won, as it seemed to have a difference.
You know, you want to give that group, KG and Pierce and Rondo, you want to give them another...